and I'ma get it. You know I be on the way.
I am going to insert my hand in the collar. I go to knee on belly position, and my hand is in the collar, really deep. It would be advantageous if he would turn into me a little bit. So very often from here, they'll like push the knee off, boom, and they turn in. That's great, that's what I want. Okay. I wanna grab, I create a ridge. I wanna grab that ridged material, circle my elbow around, and then drop down. So top one becomes a wall, bottom wrist goes up and into the neck. So we're knee on belly position, I get really deep, he pushes that knee off and turns into me. That's what I want, it really helps you. Okay, grab that ridge, have your forearm start about middle of his head and then circle it around so it's tight. Then come up with the wrist at the very end. Let's do it on the other side. So guys, I'm here, knee on belly, open that collar up, let him push the knee off, turn into you, grab the collar, circle your forearm around, that becomes the wall, bottom wrist comes up, and take your choke, all right? One, two, three. So basic choke where it's palm up, palm down. Really, the one that enters first, you form the wall with the top hand, the bottom hand, you raise that elbow up, and that's really going into the neck, okay? Now, here's a different choke. Some people call it the Terminator choke. I think it's pretty good. If I'm in knee on belly position, and I'm going for a choke like that, maybe he hasn't turned into me, but he's flat, I'm going, he blocks, okay? I'm gonna grab his gi at his wrist and then come and turn him into me, very similar. Then I block his tricep with my chest and roll my hand up and get the tap, okay? Sometimes you can try it there, and if that doesn't work, then you work your hand in for the number two, okay? So we're here, knee on belly position, he's a little more flat, I'm going for that choke, he blocks it, okay? My hand goes to the cuff, I like four fingers in the cuff, and I will pull this across. It's no different than a triangle choke or anything else. You want the arm pressing into the, and shoulder pressing into the neck. To get him to turn a little bit more, I might bring my knee off of him, okay? Put all my body weight onto that tricep, okay? And then I can roll this in. I just roll that bottom wrist up into the neck. If it doesn't happen, then I will circle and we'll do the first one that we did. So a good follow-up, okay? So let's work on that Terminator choke, pulling the arm across. One, two, three. Number one, so when he blocks, I can grab the cuff. Sometimes that's great to turn him over. Sometimes you just grab the tricep and come into position. There's also a cool arm bar here that you can hit either against here or, you know, bring your leg up into it, whatever. You can play around with that. Even just threatening that might bring it in and help you adjust your angle so you can go back into your choke. Now, say we're back at number one. I'm bringing this around and I just can't get it done. Sometimes I will dive into him and lean my weight and allow him to come up just a little bit, but I catch him with my hook. And that allows me to lift my elbow just a little bit more. So on this next round, just play around with, so you can come here, boom, we're coming in. I almost have it, but I don't quite have it, so lean into his neck, let him come up, and now you're gonna be able to pull with your lat and pull your elbow back and really tighten the choke. Okay, just play with those variations. One, two, three. So in this particular instance, it's gonna be from half guard. This is one of the ways that I really started to understand the darts choke a little more. He's got an underhook, and I want his arm to get in front of him. So I'm not gonna be able to move it. So I have to threaten an arm lock. I'm gonna take my arm and straighten it on the ground, and as I straighten it, it straightens his arm and pushes against his elbow. Okay, so it's a little bit mysterious because we both have black keys here, but you can punch the ground, okay, and then I'm gonna rotate my body too. Boom. And then he'll turn that in, and when he turns it in, oh, I dive my shoulder below his lat, come into position, and then we have a darce choke right here. Let's try it on the other side. So I'm in half guard. He has an underhook. Sometimes it's not enough to just get it here. I need to actually rotate my body. I'm gonna open up a little bit of space. And then he threads this arm through because he doesn't like it getting locked. Right? So I put that pressure on, he threads it through, I dive my hand underneath. I can pull on the head as well, okay? I'm gonna get my pinky into the crook of my elbow. I don't want it compressed and weird. I want it flat. Grab here, and then I'm gonna roll my wrist up, just like in the other choke. I'm gonna roll my wrist up and push forward with my chest, okay? So this is a great technique. It's a great technique, and occasionally you see it in MMA too. Guys, don't like that, you can push that arm through, come through here, and get your darts choke from half guard, all right? One, two, three. So this arm that I'm trying to straighten his arm out with, I'm gonna punch the ground and then straighten, okay? It's a little bit difficult to see, but I want to straighten my arm by punching the ground with a fist, and then I can rotate and extend and then get that. Okay, so we're in here. Sometimes you don't have any problem at all getting that choke, okay? And roll your wrist up at the end, you're flexing, you're dropping your chest, doing all that. Sometimes you have to put your hand, instead of the pinky going in the crook of your elbow, for bigger people, sometimes you have to modify that and just put your hand flat on your forearm. And then you roll it up just the same, right? So if you can get this, really good. If you can't, then be satisfied with just the middle of your forearm, flat palm, and then you can roll it up as you compress, okay? That's for the big guys, and anytime you find yourself a little bit short to finish that, okay? All right, darts, one, two, three. Man on a mission, I'm a kidding, you know I be on the way. Yeah, I'm on the way. On the way.